What's up, it's your boy Dragon back with another tutorial. In today's video, I'm gonna be showing you guys how to make what you see on the screen. So let's just straight into it. First thing you wanna do is go to File, then you wanna go to New, then you wanna do 1280 by 720. Once you do that, you wanna go on Twitter and get your screenshots. I already have mine right here. If you have trouble getting your screenshots, just hit me up on Twitter and I'll tell you guys how to do it. So once you have all that and you have the right pixels, we're just gonna cut out this My Player. And we're actually gonna cut this out. And if you need to learn how to cut out, just look at my cut out tutorial. If you need any other help, I'll just let you know how to do it. So I'm gonna do this and I'll be back with you guys. So now that I'm done cutting all of this out, I'm gonna show you guys what to do. So you just want to hold control, click on all these layers right here. I'm gonna make this down here bigger. We're just gonna make it like this size right there. All right, so now that we've done this, we want to go to hue and saturation down here. We want to turn the lightness down like this. Once you turn the lightness down, you want to create a new layer, hit B on your keyboard, and then go with color picker, pick the color white, and then tap about 3 times behind this My Player. I do like that. Once you do this, put it on overlay, not soft light, put it on overlay, and you can just turn lightness down on this a little bit more, and you can also make this layer a little bit bigger, look like this. Next thing we're gonna do is hit J on our keyboard, and we're just gonna get rid of this My Player right here, and you just wanna kind of do like this. Once you got rid of them, I'm gonna go to File, open, I'm gonna go to my pack, and you can just go in here and get the shot meter. If you need my pack, let me know on Twitter. That just hit Control V, and then you can just put this like right here. Now what I'm gonna do is make this My Player a little bit bigger. I'll make them about this big, and you can hit Control S since you did all that. But after I made them that big, I'm basically gonna hit J on my keyboard and just come behind them and do this right here. You can't really tell. If you're worried about the takeover down there, you can also hit J on that to fix it up. If you just wanna do like this. All right, so once you fix all that up, you can just go to File, Open, and then go in my pack, and you can just get the green slash also. Just hit Control C when you get it. Come over here, hit Control V. Once you hit Control V, we're just gonna cover up his feet since it looks kinda messed up. We'll cover up his feet and then do like this. Our next thing I'm gonna do is come over here, go to filter, camera off filter, and we're gonna lighten that My Player up because it still looks kind of dark. So now you line them up, just turn your highlights up. To light them up, turn your highlights up, and mostly just your highlights because that got it about right. All right, so once you did that, what you can do is create a layer behind this dude, and then go about right here, make your brush bigger. You can hold Alt and then do like the right on your mouse to make that bigger at the same time. Just click behind him like 3 times, make that layer overlay, and do it again. Make one linear dot. I'm just hitting Control G because I'm duplicating the layer. Oh, and then you make it again. Have that on screen. Now, I currently don't have my mouse on, like my keyboard, but I'm gonna put it on in the middle of the video so you guys can see better. Just follow what I'm doing. And you can lower the opacity on these at the top a little bit. And once you do that, you can just hit Control S. I'm not gonna do it because I already made this, but you can just have something like that. So I'm gonna show you guys what to do next. Once we have this, I'm gonna show you guys how to add this, but I'm gonna just add this first since it's easier to do. So I'm just gonna go to File, Open, and then I'm gonna go get the jump shot thing. But remember to put all my files in the comment section, so all of this should be in the comment section. So you just want to put this about right here, and if I don't put it in there, just hit me up on Twitter to get it. Alright, so next thing I'm gonna add is this right here, and this is probably gonna be the hardest part, but it'll be the best looking part because it's pretty unique, and you barely see people do this on the thumbnail, so I'm gonna show you guys how to do all of this right here. So basically what I did, I just went to a video on YouTube, zoomed in, and held my shift key, I held my Windows key, my shift key, and then hit S. So I just did this, went across like so, and then got the screenshot. Come back to Photoshop, hit Control V like you see me do, and you just want to put this above everything. So basically what I'm gonna do is hit W on my keyboard, click on this, and hit Control X, and that's gonna cut out a lot of stuff. So what we need to focus on now is cutting out these little marks and stuff. So I'm gonna just speed up me cutting it out, the cutting out process, but you guys gonna once you cut all of this out, just hit M on your keyboard, go across like this till you have all of this section, then hit Control J, because we're not going to need this. We can just duplicate and make the same thing as that. So now that we got that right there, what we're going to do is just cut this out, and basically you can just hit L on your keyboard, come right here, and then get this part from the, like that, come around, and then once you hit that, just hit Control J. So once you have this piece, what you want to do is make it bigger and put it like right there. Well, actually, no. We're going to put it right here, and then we're going to move this over. We just hold Control so we can move all of these. So now that we have that, what we can do is go back and look at this, and we can also take this piece right here and just do what you see me doing. So do that, hit Control J. Now that we have this right here, what we can do is we can just put the 100% thing like over here, make this layer a little bit taller. And what we're gonna have to do is just cut around this and hit Control J again and show you guys exactly what to do. We would do this, come right here, and just put it like that. Do that, we can just cut this part out up here at our Eagle Dollar thing. Alright, so now that we got this, we just want to hit M on our keyboard, and we want to cut this out separately, so you can just hit Control J when you get on number 100%. So now what we're going to do is add drop shadow. So we're going to go to blend option on this, and we're just going to add a drop shadow to it like so. And it's up to you guys which one you want to choose, but I'm gonna choose that and hit right click, copy it, and we're gonna paste it on this. We're also gonna paste it on this, and we're gonna paste it on this. Now we got a drop shadow on everything. Make sure you hit Control and S, go to blending options on this right here, and with the drop shadow on this, we're gonna turn the distance. We're gonna turn size down and put the distance up a little bit like that. And just up the opacity. Now we do that, you want to hit Control S. Make sure you save it because you don't want your stuff crashing or whatever. But once we got this, we're going to cut out the Andre Eagle Dollar thing shaver too. So we're going to go across, hit Control J like so. And what we can do now is we can enlarge that. And once we enlarge it, we can just go across like so. And I'm going to show you, I'm going to actually show you guys how to make your own. So just make a little layer. And then you can kind of select the colors off of this and turn it darker. Hit G on your keyboard, do something like that, and I'm gonna show you guys what to do. So I'm gonna just name this the name on here is Shaq. You can name the name whatever you want, but I'm gonna show you guys how to do it. Go over here, and this is the font I use. So I'm gonna make these words bigger, and I'll be back with you guys. Rasterize your text if you want to, but basically we just gonna make it smaller and put it up here. And a good thing about making your own box, you can actually make it longer if the text is way too small. So if I wanted my text to be this long, I can just go to my box over here, hold shift, and then drag it out like that, so you can have something like that. So now we got our box, what we can do is just basically group both of those layers like you saw me just do, and that's with my keyboard on so you can slow the video down. So if you see what I just did, it's good. If you need to slow it down, you can, but I basically just group the layers together, and I do a lot of videos. So next thing I'm gonna do is have a little line coming to Shaq also, so I'm gonna get that line and show you guys how to put it there. So you just hit Control J on the line, bring it up here, put it towards Shaq or the Shaq name, and then hit Control S to make sure you don't lose your work. And I'm gonna go get a picture of Shaq right click, copy image, and then you hit Control V and go to the, hit M on your keyboard, go to this tool, and I'm gonna just cut Shaq out like so. Put it right here, like right up on it. And yeah, something like that. So now you can go to blender options on it, add the drop shadow. This is drop shadow, and you can add a stroke to it. I'm gonna make the stroke a little bit smaller. So now that you have that stroke, you got something like that right there. Now we're gonna get back to this dude. You just wanna go to blend options on this my player. And if you want to, you can just go over here and do this one first. So I'll go to my blend options, drop shadow. And then you just wanna right click, copy image, go over here, paste. And we can go back and look at the differences. So this is basically the default one. If you just need the settings off of this, I can show you guys the actual drop shadow if you just want to copy it. And I can show you the drop shadow on this because I actually use this one on everything. So if you need that drop shadow, there you go. But I just wanted to switch this one up a little bit. All right. So now that we have this, you can kind of turn your lightness down a little bit more if you want to. But if that's pretty much all you need, we can create a new layer and just bring it down here. We can make it bigger with the barcode, and just basically go to the color white and click behind this a little bit also. So we turn the overlay a little bit down on this one though. So make sure you hit Control S, and once you hit Control S, that's basically it. And we can just right click, add a layer down here, put a black border, so you don't get the color black, and go around like this. So you just want to go all the way around, and we're gonna make that soft light. Then we're gonna make one on top, go all the way around, and we're gonna lower the opacity. After we do that, I don't know what I just said, go to file, open, go to your effects. I'm gonna get the animated lines, hit Control C, come over here, hit Control V, and we just gonna put this below the black bar. So once we do this, we just make it bigger. And yeah, kind of put it like that. So now we can merge visible because we've done. And we can go to camera raw. And you can just mess with the settings. I'm not really going to skip this part though. So you can just turn shadows up, highlights up, turn your contrast up. And I usually turn my blacks down and just turn my whites up, kind of like that. You can mess with the clarity even if you want to, or you can turn it down. Now, I made a video on how to use this stuff, but I'm still not that good at it. But turn your vibrance, saturation, mess with your sharpening. You don't even have to turn on every layer. I'm just doing this. You guys can sit here and mess with it longer because I got like school in like 15 minutes. So, yeah. And even if you want to mess with this, this light messing with the green bar and stuff like that down there. So, it's just like a tip or whatever. And if you mess with the reds, this messing with the shirt. So, you can even change the shirt color. But I'm not gonna mess with that too much though. But you can turn your grain. I usually put my grain on 5, and we can hit OK. All right, so you can see the difference. So now that we hit OK, we can go to Magic Bullet Looks on the filter, and then just hit this right here. This is the only one I use really. Once we do that, what we do is go to our filter. We're gonna add Topaz Labs also. So go to Filter, Topaz Labs. And then I'm gonna just add mild details like so. And yeah, kind of have like that. Apply it. We're gonna make a new layer after we get done. Hold Alt, click right here. Boom. Click right there. Boom. Click over here like that. And then, yep. And then come back over here. So after we do that, we just gonna put the layer on linear dodge add, lower the opacity, and merge visible. After we merge visible, what we're gonna do is go to filter, we can go to noise and reduce noise. And once you reduce noise, I have mine like 5. So this is how you make the thumbnail. If you enjoyed the video, make sure you drop a like and subscribe. It will be appreciated. So peace out.